वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव सीन वेरियस ग्रैनुलेशन इक्विपमेंट्स एंड वी ऑल्सो कॉल्ड देम एज ग्रैनुलेटर्स। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट और आई हैव कम अप विद द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक ऑफ ग्रैनुलेशन, दैट इज मैकेनिज्म्स ऑफ ग्रैनुलेशन। व्हाट एक्चुअली वी नीड टू लर्न इन दिस पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक इज दैट हाउ एक्चुअली ग्रैनुल्स आर फॉर्म, which are the various mechanisms, means say which are the various bonding mechanisms or which are the various granule formation mechanisms are there, which are these mechanisms that we want to learn in this particular topic, that is mechanisms of granulation. Means whatever we are going to learn in this particular topic, it is little bit deeper one, means we need to study or we need to learn various we can say forces that will responsible for formation of aggregates of particles, why the aggregation will form, what are the reasons behind the formation of aggregation of these particles. These all particularly these all things comes under this particular topic, that is mechanisms of granulation. Initially we will look towards the learning objectives of today's lecture, that is after completion of this lecture you will able to firstly understand various particle bonding mechanisms, means why the particles will get bond to each other and by which mechanisms they will get bond or they will form a bond in between them, that we are going to learn firstly. And then secondly we will going to learn various mechanisms of granule formation, after forming these bonds how that bonded particles will get convert in a uniform size of granules, that we are going to learn in today's lecture. Now initially we will see little bit introduction of granulation, then all of you know that granulation is the process of collecting particles together by creating bond between them. Okay, means the whenever the granules formation is there, all of you know that granules are nothing but aggregates of particles. Why these aggregation are formed? These are formed due to the bonds in between them. Now bonds are formed by the compression or by using a binding agent. Okay, these bonds are either formed by compression when we are using a dry granulation technique or by using a binding agent whenever we are using a wet granulation technique. The granulation process combines one or more powder particles and forms a granule that will allow tableting. If the granules are formed, then and then only tableting is possible. And how that granulation form? By combining one or two more powder particles. Okay, then generally this is important, granules typically have a size range from 0.2 to 4 millimeter depending on their subsequent use. For what purpose we are using these granules, depending on that the granules size will be defined from 0.2 to 4 mm depending on their subsequent use. Okay, this is all about the little bit introduction, whatever we have learned in the last lectures, that introduction we have seen in this particular slide, that is what is the granulation, okay, why granules are formed, these are certain reasons we have look in this particular site now particular slide. Then next important, now we'll start with the actual part, mechanisms of granulation. Okay, in mechanisms of granulation, initially mechanisms of granulation are categorized into two groups, that is particle bonding mechanism and secondly mechanism of formation of granule or mechanism of granule formation. These two mechanisms, the mechanism of granulation is divided, first is called as a particle bonding mechanism. In this particular particle bonding mechanism we are learning how the particles will get bind to each other and which are the mechanisms or which are the reasons by which particles will get bind to each other, that we are going to learn in a particle bonding mechanisms. And secondly in a mechanisms of formation of granule, in that particular bit we are going to learn after bonding these particles how these particles will get convert into uniform shape of granules. Okay, that we are going to learn in a mechanism of formation of granules. Then firstly we will start with the particle bonding mechanisms. Now particle bonding mechanisms again is of five types, means there are five reasons why there is a particle bonding will happen between two particles. The first reason is that adhesion and cohesion forces in immobile liquid films between the individual primary particles. Okay, means there is a development of adhesion and cohesion forces in the immobile liquid film, that is important word, immobile liquid film, between the individual primary powder particle. That is first reason. In subsequent slide, we are going to learn it in a detail. Then second reason is that interfacial forces in mobile liquid film. Now interfacial development of interfacial forces in mobile liquid film, that will also leads to the formation of particle bonding. And then third one is the formation of solid bridge after solvent evaporation. Means whenever we are going for the drying, after drying the solvent will get evaporated and your particles will get bound to each other. That is third we can say reason of particle bonding. And then fourth one, attractive forces between solid particles, or development of attractive forces in between a solid particles during the subsequent operations of your granulation. There might be a development of certain attractive forces. That is one of the reason for the particle bonding mechanism. And lastly, mechanical interlocking, means two particle mechanically get interlocked in between each other so that they will form a strong bond in between them and the particle will get bind to each other. Okay, these are the five different we can say reasons why the particle bonding will happens between the particles at the time of granulation. Now we'll start with first, then secondly, mechanism of granule formation. Now mechanism of granule formation again divided into three phases. First phase is called as the nucleation phase, second phase is called as a transition phase, and last phase is called as a ball growth. Okay, in ball growth, the ball growth means actually a development of your uniform shape of granules. That is last stage in the mechanism of granule formation. In that ball growth, this ball growth or development of uniform shape of or uniform size of granules is again by a four mechanisms. That is, first one is as a collisions formation, second one is a breakage, third one is called as a layering, and last one is called as an abrasion transfer. Okay, these are the various mechanisms by which development of uniform size of granules, that is ball growth, we also called it as a ball growth. And it is divided into four groups, that is collisions formation, breakage, layering, and abrasion transfer. Now firstly we look towards the particle bonding mechanism. Now in this particular bit, formation of granules requires formation of bonds between powder particles so that they can adhere. Means whenever there is a need of granulation, the particle must form a bond in between them. Okay, and to form that bond, after forming that bond, only then only the granules will have required strength. Okay, the bond must be sufficiently strong to avoid the breakdown of granules into powders in specific handling operations. Means whatever the bonds will form by using these mechanisms, this should be very strong so that it will not furtherly get breakdown whenever we are doing compression or whenever we are handling our granulation. At that time it should not get break, so that this bond should have sufficient strength, okay, to avoid the breakdown of our particles. Now in that first mechanism, in classification also we have seen, that is adhesion and cohesion forces in immobile liquid film. That is very important. Now this particular word, that is immobile films. Now what do you mean by immobile? Can anyone tell me what is the meaning of word immobile?
Stationary.
Okay, stationary, that is a correct word for immobile. We can say stationary means which is not moving. Okay, which is not moving. That is important word in this particular we can say mechanism. That is adhesion and cohesion, means development of adhesion and cohesion forces in immobile films. Now what do you mean by immobile films? The formation of films around your particles whenever we are doing wet granulation, we are adding binder solution, binder liquid, okay, or sometimes granulation as it is having certain moisture. Okay, that moisture will accumulate around your powder particle and it will form an immobile film which is stationary. Means that particular binder solution or moisture will not move from that particular surface of your particle. That's why we called it as a immobile film, that is stationary film. Okay, now we will look it in a detail. In sufficient liquid, if sufficient liquid is present in the powder to form a very thin and immobile layer, there will be an effective decrease in interparticulate distance. Whenever there is a presence of this particular liquid in your particles, then there is a decrease in interparticulate distance and increase in a contact area between the particles. That is the reason why little amount of moisture will also bind your powders. If you can observe the powder which contains moisture and the powder which is completely dry or which doesn't have a moisture, the powder which is doesn't have a moisture, it is completely free flowing. Okay, and those powder which is having moisture, they will have little bit less flowability. Okay, the reason is that this particular powders, those powders which contains a moisture or sufficient liquid, they will form a damp mass. Okay, and due to that damp mass, the interparticulate distance between powder particle will get a decrease and the increase in contact area between two particles. Okay, and that is the reason why the adhesion forces will promoted in this particular immobile films. Okay, that is the first reason. The bond strength between the particles are also increased. Due to that, the bond strength will also increases. Okay, the bond strength, due to the presence of this sufficient amount of liquid, the bond strength will also increase. Why this happen? Because of the van der Waal forces. Okay, it is all due to the van der Waal forces. As the van der Waal forces of attraction are proportional to the particulate diameter, this particularly depends on the particular diameter and inversely proportional to the square of the distance of separation. Okay, that is inversely proportional to the square of distance of separation. Such a films may present at a residual liquid. Okay, only present at a residual liquid after granules prepared by wet granulation. Okay, it is only you can observe in a pen, granules are prepared by a wet granulation and have been dried. After when we are going to dry, then and then only these films will prepare or will produce a particle bonding. Okay, this is adhesion and cohesion forces in immobile liquid films. Now in this particular only, in dry granulation, instead of using our binder solution, in dry granulation majorly the pressure is used will increase the contact area. Okay, in dry granulation there is again development of adhesion and cohesion forces, but not due to the wetting, or we can say moisture, but due to the when we apply the pressure, the two particles, the contact area will get increases between the two particles and the adsorption layer and decrease interparticulate distance. And due to that, whenever we are applying the pressure, interparticulate distance will go on decreasing and this will contribute to the final strength of granule, and due to that there is a formation of final strength in a granules. Then next point is that thin immobile layer may also be formed by highly viscous solution. Whenever we are using highly viscous solution in the granulation, in a granulation, if we are using binder as a starch paste which is highly viscous solution, okay, or highly viscous solution of, we can say, adhesives, or we can also call it as a binders, and so the bond strength will be greater than the produced by the mobile films. So that in that case, the bond strength, due to their stickiness, highly viscousness, the bond strength in a produce is increased by the as compared to the mobile films. Now what is mobile films? That will come in a second type of mechanism or second reason in a particle bonding. Okay, this is all about the first one, that is adhesion and cohesion forces in immobile films. Okay, now we'll start with the second, that is interfacial forces in mobile liquid film. Now what do you mean by interfacial forces in mobile liquid film? Now what happens here in that particular, again, mobile liquid films, that is very important. Now it is a mobile liquid film. As in a previous, you have said that in immobile it means that stationary, and mobiles means it is a moving. Okay, moving films means the films from one particle will get move on another particle, or the liquid will get movable in this particular mechanism. Okay, now we will look. This is particularly this mechanism is observed in a wet granulation techniques. Okay, during wet granulation, the liquid is added to the powder mix and will distributed as a film around and between the particles. Means whenever, just memorize the process of granulation. How we are doing the granulation? Firstly, we are mixing all our ingredients, means your drug, your bind, your diluent, disintegrants, that we are all mixing them, and after that we are adding binder solution in that so that it will form a wet mass. Then we will pass it through the screen, then we will collect the granules, and then we will dry it. This all for just visualize this process, and then you will come to know how the interfacial forces in mobile film will work. Okay, now what happened in this particular mechanism, the powder mix, and whenever we are adding granulation liquid into the powder mixture, what will happen? The granulation liquid will get distributed in all powder as a film, and this film is around the particles and in between the particles. So that is the reason this film is a mobile one, movable one. Okay, that is the reason why we called this particular films are a mobile liquid films. The reason is that these films are movable in between a particles. Then sufficient liquid usually adapted to exceeds that necessary for the immobile layer and to produce a mobile film. Up to what we are adding a liquid, it is a sufficient so that it will overcome the immobile layer and produce a mobile film. Till that only we are adding a granulating fluid to produce a wet mass. Okay, and after adding this, what actually happens in a granular state, that we are going to learn now. There are three stages. Then after that, there are during this process three stages of water distribution form in between particles, as shown in figure. That figure will come in the next slide, but it will show the three stage three stages are important, that is pendular state, funicular state, and capillary state. These three stages, that is pendular, funicular, and capillary state, are important for the granulation, and droplet is not required for the granulation. That's why I have said here three stages of water distribution between the particles are important during the granule formation. Now we will look towards the figure. What that figure will actually explains you what is pendular, funicular, capillary, and droplet state. Now this is the figure. You can observe in this figure. Suppose consider these are the five particles of your powders. Okay, it is in a dry state prior to the granulation. Okay, now the G will explain here. You can observe the G will explain addition of granulating fluid, means your binder solution or granulating fluid, and D suggests the drying. Okay, now firstly, suppose consider this is a circles, these five circles 2, 3, 4, and 5, these five circles will represents your powder particles, and we are adding in this powder particle initially a little amount of your granulating fluid. Then what will happen? The granulating liquid will form these liquid bridges in these four particles. Whatever these bridges you can observe here, I am marking these bridges. These bridges will get formed in between a particle initially. Okay, we called it as a liquid bridges. Yala ka mantat liquid bridges. Okay, this particular thing is called as a liquid bridges. And when we dry this, then these liquid bridges will get converted into a solid bridges. How that solid bridges are formed, that we are going to learn in a next mechanism. Okay, this particular thing, initial thing, that is formation of liquid bridges, start in a pendular state. Okay, that's why this is the initial state, that is a pendular state. Then again we are adding next increment of our granulating fluid. The next increment addition, the solid liquid bridges will start displacing air in between these particles. Okay, whatever the air you can observe in a pendular state, whatever I am marking, this red is all your air present in the particles after formation of solid bridges. And in funicular state, this air will start displaced. You can observe here the air will get displaced. Okay, the air displacement will start, and that particular state is called as a funicular state. Okay, funicular state. After funicular state, again we are adding little bit of granulating fluid. Then the four particles, whatever the four particles are there, in between these all particles, the whole air in between these particles will get displaced, and due to that the interparticulate distance, whatever the interparticulate distance, which will go on decreasing, and it will form your granules like this. Okay, it will form your granule like this when the interparticulate distance will get decreased. Okay, it will form a granule like this and you will get a final granule, and that particular state is called as a capillary state. Okay, again, if you are here, we need to stop our addition of granulating fluid. Okay, but if you are go on adding here, we have in on this arrow you can observe that is a cross mark. Okay, it is a cross mark is over here. By addition of granulating fluid is not required after that particular capillary state. Why? Because when we add it more, instead of forming your weight mass, the powder will get converted into suspension form, because granulating fluid will become more as compared to the your powder particles, and it will form a suspension. That is the reason we are not adding further granulating fluid, or that particular stage formation of suspension, or we also called it as a droplet state, is not required in a granulation. Now in a reverse manner, what will happen? If you are adding more, if it will get converted into suspension, we can overcome it by simply a drying. Okay, if you dry this, again this particular suspension will get converted into capillary state. When we dry capillary state, again it will go convert into funicular state. When we dry it again it will get convert into your pendular state. But again, whenever we are going on a reverse pendular state, when we go on drying, we will not get a dry state prior to granulation. Means you will get a dry granules, you will get a dry granules, but you will not get a powder. That's why it is not required after formation of pendular state. Okay, this is all. Again, here I have mentioned that whenever there is a mark and cross, then that is not required or undesirable state in that particular location. This will explain all the stages in your, we can say, interfacial forces in immobile liquid films. Okay, and why this particular interparticulate distance will get decreased? Because of interfacial forces, due to interfacial forces, or we can say capillary action. Due to capillary section action, these particular particles will come together and bind to each other. Okay, now we'll firstly look one by one each step, the pendular state. Now first stage is that pendular stage. In that, firstly, this stage usually occurs at a low moisture level. Okay, whenever we are adding very low granulating fluid, in that one particular only you can observe the appearance of pendular state. In this state, the particles are held together by lens shaped ring of liquid. Okay, lens shaped ring of liquid means what? You can observe this is a lens shaped ring of liquid. Okay, this particular thing is a lens shaped ring of liquid. Okay, these cause adhesion because of the surface tension forces of the liquid air interface and the hydrostatic suction pressure in the liquid bridge. Due to the interfacial forces or surface tension forces, the hydrostatic suction pressure develops in that particular liquid bridge, and it will bind your powder particle or start binding your powder particle at pendular state. Okay, then next state is that funicular state, that whatever we have seen in a next stage is that funicular state. In funicular state, what happened? This state represents an intermediate stage between pendular and capillary state. It is intermediate, means in between stage of your pendular and capillary stage. When the air start to displace, as I have explained in a previous slide, when the powder particles will get convert from pendular to funicular, the air, you can observe in this figure also, here the air is present. You can see this is all air presence. And in whenever the drug will start, whenever the particle will start going in a funicular state, then this air will start displaced. You can observe here, the air will get displaced from here. Okay, in between the particles, and the particles arrange in a funicular state. Okay, means the start of displacement of air in between the particles is nothing but your funicular state. Okay, attainment of funicular state in a granulation. Okay, after funicular state, the particles arrange themselves in a capillary state. That is next step. That and there is no air in between them. Okay, after this funicular state, when we are adding next state, then we will get a capillary state, and there is no air present in between the particles. Now when all the air has been displaced from in between a particle, the capillary state is arise. When capillary state will arise? When all the air has been displaced from between the particles. Then the capillary state is reached. The particles are held by capillary suction. That is important. Why the particles will get bond to each other? Because of capillary suction at the liquid air interface. Means whatever the liquid air interface in between them, due to that the capillary suction will form, which is now only at the granule surface. Okay, it will remain only at the granule surface. Most granule tensile strength increases about 3 times between pendular to capillary state. Means whatever the granules which will go in stages from pendular to capillary, the granule tensile strength will get increased up to its 3 times. Okay, whatever the tensile state at the dry state and whatever the tensile state at the capillary state, it will go on increasing by three times. Okay, this is a stage is the most desirable stage in the process of granulation. Means it is the most desirable stage in a process of granulation. Now you can observe in funicular, initially there is a funicular state. Some amount of your air in between particles will get displaced here, but in this particular capillary stage you can observe whole air will get displaced from the particles. Okay, after addition of more granulating fluid, that particular state is called as a capillary state. And why that capillary state will bind the particles? Because of a capillary suction at the liquid air interface. Whatever the capillary suction is between this liquid and air interface is there, this capillary suction will bind your particles. That is capillary state. Then next one we will look droplet state, or it is also called as a suspension state. Okay, now in a droplet state, what actually happens, this is another state in process, but this step is not, is undesirable, or we can say not required. Okay, here that's why we have said here addition of granulating fluid not desirable. We have marked it here as a cross. This will be important in the process of granulation by spray drying of a suspension. If you are doing a granulation by preparing a suspension, then in that case only this particular step is needed. Otherwise, this is not desirable. After that, you can take the note, that is very important. Whatever the mechanism we have seen now, these wet bridges or solid liquid bridges are only temporary structures. Okay, these are the only temporary structures in a wet granulation, because the moist granule will be dried. This is you can observe only when we are adding a granulating fluid, and these are temporary one till the liquid bridges are formed, and whenever we are preparing a moist granulation, they are however prerequisite for the formation of solid bridges. Okay, means these are requirement. Liquid bridges or wet bridges are requirement for the formation of liquid bridges formed by the adhesives present in the liquid. Whatever that liquid or granulating fluid contains a binder or adhesive, okay, to this binder will going to form a solid bridges. But to form the solid bridges, initially there is a need of formation of liquid bridges or material that dissolves in a granulating liquid. This is shown in the next mechanism, that is formation of solid bridges. Okay, up till now we have in the particle bonding finish with the two mechanism. First formation of liquid immobile film, then secondly interfacial forces in between mobile liquid film, and now we will start with the formation of solid bridge. Now whatever the liquid bridge form in a second mechanisms, these liquid bridges now will get converted into a solid bridge and give final strength to your granules. Means your granules now finally become a aggregates of particles by the conversion of them into the solid bridges. A solid bridge is formed by adhesives, means whatever the binders present in the liquid, by or by materials which are dissolved in the granulating liquid. Means the solid liquid formation is due to the binders or whatever the material is dissolved in your granulating liquid. Due to that only the solid bridge are formed, and the solid bridge are formed by the three methods or three mechanisms. First one is called as a partial melting, second one is called as a hardening of binder, and third one is called as a crystallization of dissolved substances. These are the three mechanisms by which the liquid bridge will get converted into solid bridge or direct formation of solid bridge in your particles. Now firstly we will look towards the, this is actually a formation of solid bridge mechanism. We will look towards the formation of mechanism for the solid bridge. Spraying of solution, whenever we are doing a granulation, we spray our granulating fluid over a powders. This is a liquid, this is a powders. Okay, we are spraying it over this, then it will form a this is a, we can say, funicular and pendular and capillary state. Then this is your actually formation of solid bridges when we are doing it solidified, or we can say drying. The whatever the liquid in between them, it will get, this liquid will get evaporated. Okay, and then whatever the that liquid contains, either a binder or anything which is dissolved in that particular liquid, which will get solidified due to the evaporation of solvent, and the final granules will get formed. This is actually a formation of solid bridges, and these solid bridges are formed by the three mechanism, that is partial melting, hardening of binder and crystallization of dissolved substances. Now we will look towards the first, partial melting. Now what actually partial melting means? The pressure used in a dry granulation, generally partial melting will shows only in a we can say dry granulation state. In that, what happened, the pressure used in a dry granulation methods may cause a melting of low molecular point materials, or no low low melting point materials. Now what happens in partial melting, whenever we are adding our these granules for the compression granulation, whenever we are compressing a powder particles, if the that powder contains a certain ingredients which are having very low melting point, such consider such as a stearic acid salts, we are generally using as a antiadherents or glidants. Okay, that we also call them as a magnesium stearate. Okay, these are the stearic acid salts. Okay, if these salts present, they are having very low melting point. Whenever we using these in a compression, whenever we are applying pressure in that particular thing, the temperature of that particular system will go on increasing, and due to increasing of that temperature, the particles of this low melting point material will start melting. Okay, where the particle touch and high pressure are developed, the particles will bind together, it will get melt and then bind together, and crystallization will take place. Hence the pressure is, once the pressure is removed, means when at the pressure condition it will go on melting, and when we remove a pressure, it will again solidify, it will again get convert into solid and crystallize, and due to that we can say the partial melting of these particular solids will bind your particles. Now how actually it happens, I will just draw it over here. Suppose these two particles are there. Okay, consider these two particles, this is one and this two, and whenever we are applying pressure, okay, we are applying pressure on these two particles by this manner. Okay, they will come together like this. Okay, and still we are go on applying pressure, it will become very contact to each other, and whatever the interface here, okay, it will start melting at the interface. It will melt here, and bottom particle will melt here, and it will get convert into a liquid. Okay, when it is in a pressurized condition, when we relieve in a pressurized condition, this liquid will become solid, and it will form a solid bridge in between these two particles, and these two particles will get bind to each other. Okay, this is actually a mechanism of partial melting. Now next one is a hardening of binder solution. Okay, this will actually observe in a partial melting, will observe in a your dry granulation, then hardening of binder is observed in a wet granulation. Now what happen in wet granulation, when adhesives is included in the granulation, granulating solvent during a wet granulation, when we are using adhesives or binders, okay, the liquid will form liquid bridges. Okay, initially liquid bridges are formed, and the adhesives will harden or crystallize on drying. When we go for the drying, the adhesives, whatever the liquid present in the granulating solvent, or whatever the granulating solvent will be there, that solvent will get evaporated or crystallized, evaporated, and your binder solution will get crystallized, or it will become a hardened, and it will form a solid bridge to bind the particles. Then it will form a solid bridge to bind the particles. Now same thing, two liquids are there, two particles are there. Initially in between them there is a, this is a liquid bridge, we can say this is a liquid bridge. What happen when we dry this, after drying this liquid, whatever the liquid particles, it will get evaporated. Okay, after evaporation, only remaining part will be your binder, and that will get solidify and it will again form a particle bond between these two particles. This particular thing is called as a hardening of binders. Generally the binders like a polyvinyl pyrrolidone, carboxymethyl cellulose, stars are the common adhesives we are using, and they will show the mechanism of hardening of binders. Okay, then next one is a crystallization of dissolved substances. Now in this case majorly we are not using adhesives, but we are only using a granulating liquid or solvent during a wet granulation. That also forms sometimes a granules or form a particle bonding. The solvent used, now we will look towards this, whatever the solvent we are using, okay, the solvent used to mask the powder during wet granulation may partially dissolve one of the powder ingredients. Means whatever the ingredients, suppose we have using any granulating liquid, suppose we have use only water, and there are certain solubility of water. Suppose take an example of methyl cellulose. Methyl cellulose have certain solubility in your water, then partially that methyl cellulose will get dissolved in that water. When the granules are dried, then after that, when we are drying that granule, the crystallization of this dissolved material will take place, and dissolved substances then act as a hardening of binder. Then that dissolved substance will behave like a binder. Here we have not used specialized binders, but whatever the ingredients is having in your powders, that among these ingredients only one ingredient may have certain solubility in particular granulating liquid or granulating solvent. It will get dissolved in that particular, and upon drying that particular thing will behave like a hardening of binder, acts as a binder or adhesive. The rate of drying of the granules influence the size of crystal produced in the breach. It is very important by what rate. If you are drying it very fastly, then the larger particle size will occur if a drying time is longer or slower. Means when we are in this case, when we are drying particular granulation very fastly, then the hardening of binder or the crystal size of that particular dissolved substance is very low, and it will form a, we can say, brittle granules. If we are drying it very slowly for a longer time, okay, then it will form a large crystals, and their binding will be stronger as compared to the previous one. If it is therefore important that the drug does not dissolve in the granulating liquid and recrystallize, so that it is very important that whenever we are using granulating fluid, you should look the property of that granulating liquid and the solubility of your drug. Okay, the drug should not dissolve in a granulating liquid and recrystallize. Because of that reason, adverse effect on your dissolution rate of your particular drug will happens as it will get converted into a larger size of granules or smaller size of larger size of crystals or smaller size of crystal. That will the reason why the drug should not get solubilized in your granulating solvents. Then this is of third. Now up till now we have seen first adhesion and cohesion forces in immobile liquid film, then second interfacial forces in mobile liquid films, third we have seen, and lastly third we have seen formation of solid bridges, and now lastly we'll start with the attractive forces between solid particles. Now whatever the three mechanisms we have seen in the previous slides, among these are the common mechanism, but sometimes the particle bonding will be due to the attractive forces developed between the solid particles during subsequent operations. While we are doing certain operation in absence of liquid and solid bridges, okay, if there is no formation of liquid and solid bridges formed by the binding agent, there are two types of attractive forces that can operate between particles in a pharmaceutical system. Means these two type of forces is are there. Due to that, there is a possibilities of particle bonding, that is electrostatic forces and van der Waals forces. These forces significantly increase the grain size, or you can say granule size, and decreases. Then firstly we look towards the van der Waals forces. Now in van der Waals forces, what happens actually, the van der Waals forces are about 4 order of magnitude greater than the electrostatic forces. Means these are the stronger forces for the particle bonding than the electrostatic, and add to the granule strength of granule produced by the dry granulation. Mostly they will act in a dry granulation. The magnitude of these forces will increase as the distance between adjacent surface decreases. Means if the particle size between the distance between two particles will go on decreasing, at that time van der Waals forces of attraction will go on increasing. That you might have seen it in your DLVO theory. Okay, DLVO theory for your colloids in the second year, that particular thing comes when the magnitude of van der Waals forces increases and the distance between two particles or adjacent surface decreases. In dry granulation, this is achieved by using pressure. Okay, what, how that particular thing we are doing it in a dry granulation? We are applying a pressure on a particles, and due to that pressure, the interparticulate distance between two particles will go on decreasing, and there is a development of van der Waals attraction forces, and due to that there is a particle bonding. Now second one, electrostatic forces. Now what happen in electrostatic forces? Electrostatic forces may be important in a causing powder cohesion and the initial formation of agglomerates. Example, during mixing, whenever we are mixing, there is a charge development over your particles, and due to, if there is a development of charge are opposite like this, that is positive and negative, then there will be a development of attractive forces between particle, and due to that the particles will get bind to each other. In general, they do not contribute significantly to the final strength of granules. Okay, means whatever the granules are bonding formed by this particular electrostatic forces, that is not that much of strong, or it may be brittle one, or it will not give any strength to your granules. It is just a temporary one, but they will also form a we can say particle bonding. Now last one, that is mechanical interlocking. Okay, now in the mechanical interlocking, just a theory of adhesion state. Okay, it is a theory of adhesion state. Now good adhesion occurs only when the adhesive or your binder penetrates into the pores, holes and surfaces of other ingredients of the adhered surface. Means when binder will show good adhesion property, when it will penetrates into the surface of other ingredients and locks mechanically to the substrate, and then it will get locked. Okay, when it will, binder solution will penetrate in between them, other ingredients, and upon solidification it will become a lock. Okay, that due to that locking, that particular drug or that particular granule will have a particle bonding mechanism. The adhesive must not only wet the substrate, the binder's property is that it should not only wet the substrate but also have a right rheological properties. Okay, the right flowable properties, rheology, all of you know what is rheology, rheological properties, and due to that it will penetrate the pores and openings in a reasonable time. Means whatever the pores and openings present in other ingredients, due to good rheological properties, it will able to penetrate that. Now after that, the mechanical interlocking will happens in a three stages. The first stage is of mechanical interlocking is that occurs when the adhesive flows into the pores in the adhered surface or around the projection of the surface. Means whatever the surfaces are there, if binder will flows into the pores of these surfaces or around other pores of surfaces. Okay, that is first step. Then second step, what will happen? Interdiffusion. Second step is called as a interdiffusion, which results when the liquid adhesive dissolve and diffuse into other material. Now this liquid adhesive dissolve in a other material and will get adhered to the another material. That is first step. After first step, this second step will happen, and after this second step, the third stage will happen, that is the mechanism adsorption and the surface reaction and bonding will occur. Then your evaporation will of a particular bind granulating liquid will occur. Then the evaporation, due to evaporation, what will happen? Whatever the granulating liquid is there, which will get evaporated, and your particles will get bonded. Now consider, I am explaining it here in a simple figure. Suppose this is one of the we can say particle. It is having such a type of irregular surface, and this is our another particle. What will happen? The adhesives will flows like this. It will get distributed over here among these other particles. Okay, it will get distributed and it will get evaporated. After evaporation, it will form a hard surface over here. Okay, here it will form a hard surface, and these surface will stick to the another, and due to that there is a locking of these two, one and this is a second particle. These two particles will get locked together, and this locking will happen by these three stages. Which of the three stages? First, it will flows into the pores. Secondly, interdiffusion, it will diffuse into this, okay. And third stage, after adsorption, it will form a bond, okay. Then it will adsorption, after adsorption, the surface reaction and evaporation, it will form a strong bond in between a particle. This particular mechanism is called as a mechanical interlocking. This is all about the particle bonding mechanisms. Now, which are the different particle bonding mechanisms we have seen? Just tell me, which are the different particle bonding mechanisms up till now we have finished?
Adhesion and cohesion.
Okay.
Yes. In immobile phase.
Adhesion and cohesion forces in immobile phase. Second one.
Interfacial forces in mobile liquid.
Okay. Phase. Third.
Formation of a solid.
Okay. And last.
Then attractive forces between solid and particles and mechanical.
Okay. Okay. These are the various particle bonding mechanisms up till now we have finished. Which are these? First, adhesion and cohesion forces in immobile films. Second, interfacial forces in between mobile liquid films. Third one, formation of solid bridges. Fourth one, attractive forces developed, that is your van der Waals forces and electrostatic forces. And lastly, mechanical interlocking. These are the five various mechanisms we have seen in a particle bonding mechanism. After now, up till now, what happened? The particle bonds are get formed, means particle will start bind to each other, particles will get bind to each other. Now, after binding, these particles will get converted into uniform size of granules, and then only we can call them as a granules. Okay. Now, how these bonded particles will get converted into uniform size of granules, that will explain by the mechanisms of granule formation, and it is characterized by three stages. First one is called as nucleation, second one is called as a transition, and third one is called as a ball growth. Now, firstly, we will look towards the in mechanism of granule formation, how nucleation stage will work. Now, what happen in nucleation state? Granulation start with a particle-particle contact and adhesion due to liquid bridges, that we have seen in a particle bonding mechanism. A number of particles will join to form a pendular state. Okay, whatever these number of particles will join together, we know that it called as a pendular state. Further, agitation densifies the pendular bodies to the form capillary state, and these bodies act as a nuclei for the further granule growth. Means whatever the your capillary state of your granules, that particular capillary state will act as a nuclei, okay, or this is called as a nucleus formation for the granulation, and hence this mechanism is called as a nucleation mechanism. Okay, is it clear? What happens in nucleation? Whenever the particles will come together, they will initially form a liquid bridge. After drying, they will liquid bridge, and they convert into pendular state. From pendular state to, it will go in a funicular, and finally it will go to the capillary state. In the capillary state, all the air will get displaced, and whenever your particles in the capillary state, that particular capillary state act as a nucleus for your further granule development, and that's why this stage is called as a nucleation, that is development of nuclei for the further granulation state. Okay, now second one is a transition state. Now what happened in this transition? The nuclei can now you know that nuclei grows in a granulation. Now these nuclei can grow into two possible ways. Now these nuclei will grow your granules by two possible ways. First is either single particle can be added to the nuclei, means once that nuclei is formed, consider this is a nuclei formed by the your particles. Suppose these are the five particles. Okay, this is one nuclei, we can say. Now firstly, what happened? Either a single particle can added to the nuclei, means another single particles which is not nuclei, which will get added in this nuclei. That is one of the way of growing your nuclei. And secondly, by pendular bridge, or two or more nuclei may combine to the another way, another nuclei is formed in same granulation. Suppose this is another nuclei form, and this nuclei will again contribute into this. That particular stage is called as a transition state, means transition of your nuclei into further granules. Okay, that's why we can call it as a transition state. Okay, second is that two or more nuclei may combine. These are the two. Firstly, either single particles will and join to your basic nuclei, or another nuclei come and join to the your initial nuclei. That is called as a transition state. The combined nuclei will be reshaped by the agitation of the bed. Now this combined nuclei will get a shape of granule whenever we are doing the agitation or whenever we are doing the screening of our granules. This stage is characterized by presence of large number of small granules with fairly wide size of distribution. Okay, in this particular stage you can get a wide size of granule distribution. Okay, then last stage in a mechanism of granule formation, that is a ball growth, means actual development of your granule size and shape. If agitation is continue, the granule collisions will continue and produce unstable over mass system. Okay, it will produce unusable over mass system. This depend upon the amount of liquid added in the properties of material of being granulated. Now how this ball growth will occurs? The ball growth will occurs by four mechanism. In that, first one is a collisions formation. Now what happen in collisions formation? Two or more granules join to form a large granule. Collisions, all of you know the meaning of collisions. Now consider, okay, now this is the one of the granule. Okay, this is another granule. These two granules come together and form a large granule. That is called as a collisions formation, and that is final granule formation. Now second one is a breakage. In breakage, granules break into the fragments which adhere to the other granules, forming a layer of material over the surviving granule. Now what happen in a breakage? In breakage, this is initial granule, this is another granule. What happen? The another granule will get break ground, and then it will form a layer around this initial granule. You can observe in this figure, then this particular broken layer will form here a granules. Okay, layering of a granules. But in that case, why we called it as a breakage? Because one granule will remain same, but another granule will get breakdown and it will form a layer around the initial granule. That's why this is called as a breakage. That is also one of the mechanism of we can say ball growth. And then next one is a layering. Now what happened in layering? The granules are formed, but in granulation system there are certain particles which are remain in a single entity. They are not form aggregates. These particles will form a layer around your particles, around your granules. That particular thing is called as a layering, and that will be a development of your final granule. Okay, in that, when a second batch of powder mix is added to the bed of granules, the powder will adhere to the granules, forming a layer over the surface of increasing the granule size. It will form a layer and increase the granule size. That is also called as a ball growth or final development by layering. And lastly, abrasion transfer. Abrasion transfer means, now these are the two granules. Okay, due to the subsequent operations, okay, the granules will we can say abrade, or they will slide over one another, and due to that, some part of these granules without breaking directly get transferred to the another granules. That particular is called as a abrasion transfer. The agitation of granules bed leads to attrition, or we can say they will hit each other of material from granules, and these abraded material adhere to the other granules. They will abrade, and then it will get adhere to the other granule. That will called as a abrasion transfer. Okay, this is all about the ball growth. Okay, this is all about the second mechanism, that is mechanism of formation of granules. Okay, this is all about the mechanisms of granulation. Again, I am recording this particular lecture that will be available on you on this YouTube channel. You can subscribe it for the recorded videos of this particular lecture. This is over. Now we are over with the mechanisms of granulation. If you have any problem, any question, you can ask me now. Now we will again have little bit revision what we have learned today, and then I will ask any one of you some questions, and you have to unmute yourself and give me a reply. Tanuja Kakde, open your mic, unmute yourself. Okay, yes, tell sir. Me the first basic mechanisms of granulation. Mechanisms of granulation is divided into two groups. Which are these two groups?
Particle bonding.
Yes,
mechanism.
And second?
Mechanism of formation.
Okay, mechanism of granule formation. That is right. Now, now I will ask the question to. Sanket Kole, Unmute yourself.
Yes,
Now
sir.
tell me which are the different, which is the first particle bonding mechanism? First. Not all, I am asking only first. First particle bonding mechanism. Which is one?
Adhesion and cohesion forces.
Adhesion and cohesion forces in immobile film.
Yeah. Immobile
liquid. Liquid films. Okay. Then I will ask next question to the Siddhi Patwa. Which is the next mechanism? After adhesion and cohesion forces, which is the next one?
Interfacial forces in mobile liquid
film. Okay, interfacial forces in mobile liquid film. Then next, Monali Yelvande.
Yes, sir. Formation of solid
okay,
bridge.
Formation of solid bridge. Okay. The which are the various, same Monali, I am asking you, which are the various solid bridges formation mechanisms? By which mechanism solid bridges are formed? There are three mechanisms.
Yes, sir.
Solid bridges are formed by the three mechanisms. Which are these three mechanisms?
Partial
okay.
melting,
hardening
of binder,
and last
crystallization
of dissolved substance. That is right. Shraddha Bhujbal, unmute yourself. Tell me which is the next. Which is the
Hello?
Next one after formation of solid bridges? Yes. Attractive forces between a solid particle. That is right. Okay. Akash Ambilwade,
yes,
which is
sir.
Last one? Last mechanism in particle bonding?
Mechanical
okay,
interlocking.
That is mechanical interlocking. This is all about the particle bonding mechanisms. Now, next one is Vishal Jadhav. Okay, tell
yes,
me
sir.
Mechanisms of granule formation. Which are the three basic phases falls under the mechanism of granule formation?
Sir, nucleation,
yes.
Transition
and pole growth. Okay, that is right. Then Sushma Gaikwad,
yes,
tell
sir.
Me which are the various mechanisms of ball growth. Ball growth is done or happens in a granulation mechanism of granule formation is by four ways. Which are these four ways?
Breakage,
okay.
layering, ablation transfer,
okay,
and
that is right. Okay, this is all about the granulation mechanism. All of you understood these granulation mechanisms? Okay.
Yes, sir.